my simps! Y'all have asked for this video for way too long. Y'all have probably been wondering what is this answer to this so difficult question? What is up? Welcome back to another Whisker Chan Benga video. It's your boy Whisker Chan in the building. And in today's video, as you have heard, it is a very complex situation or question or topic, whatever you want to call it. What is Hu Tao's best build and why? In today's video, we are going to break this character down to the core and figure out what's her best build and why is it her best build and why will it be optimal on her and why will it make her an insane or even more insane unit than she already is. So, we're going to get right into this, but before we do, if you are new to the channel, make sure you smash that subscribe button down below and join the subscribers on the grind to 2,600 because we are almost there, guys. Let's hit that goal and keep going until we hit 3K. Y'all already know how this goes. And also, hit the notification bell to be notified of all my daily uploads because we do upload daily. Y'all already know. Bangers after bangers uploaded daily. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Anyway, also, make sure you smash that like button down below. You're going to enjoy this content. But without further ado, let's get right into this video. All right, first things first, I want to go over a little bit about Hu Tao and some things about the character in general that needs to be gone over before we even go over builds in the first place. Because of how the unit works, there's a lot to keep in mind. First off, we have the stat progression, which we should also keep in mind for depending on how you want to build stat builds, because definitely I feel like that's the most important thing here. The sets are pretty easy to, you know, figure out, but it's the stat build which you want to focus on and what are the stats you're supposed to be running on this character. Because of how this character actually works, it's absolutely insane. But anyway, let's go down. As you do know, she goes off crit damage on stat progression, has tons of HP already. I think she has the most base HP in the game. And yeah, so let's go ahead and go down. Now we have her elemental skill. This is where she transforms and deals pyro damage. So this is one thing to keep in mind. Basically, she literally, every time she goes into this form, everything she does is converted to pyro damage, and this lasts for 9 seconds. So this keeps us thinking to where we need a set with some pyro damage bonus, because since this character is going to have a transformation that literally transforms everything to pyro, and she has a elemental burst that also has something to do with pyro, we might as well build her with a pyro set. So we'll go over the sets and whatnot after, but let's go over a little bit about the character and whatnot and think about what, you know, main stats and substats we should have on her artifacts. So anyway, as you can see, her Parmida Papilio increases Hu Tao's attack based on her HP at the time of entering this state. The attack bonus gained this way cannot exceed 400% of Hu Tao's base attack. This has recently received a buff, so now we could go even higher. So basically, the more HP you have, the better, and also the more base attack you have, the better. Which means you need a really good weapon with high base attack, as well as, you know, her maxed out, and you know what I'm saying. So basically, just get as much base attack as you can. And yeah, as you do know, I just said she converts all the damage to power damage. It cannot be overridden by any other elemental infusion. Charge attacks apply the Blood Blossom effect to enemies hit, and this will increase her resistance to interruption. The Blood Blossom ticks every 4 seconds and deals pyro damage. And so that means, since the duration of this move is 8 seconds, it means it's going to tick 2 times. So say for example you're level 10, 115.2. Boom, you're going to hit 2 times, 230.4%. And then you're also going to have an attack increase based on your max HP at level 10 as well, or on the level, all the levels actually. And then every level has the same activation cost of 30% of your current HP. But anyway, as I was saying, you're going to have that attack increase, and then you're going to have the Blood Blossom debuff that you're going to be putting on your enemies. But the only sad thing is, like I said, you have to use a Blood Blossom really wise if you want to do it more than once while you're in this form. The reason I say that is because the duration is 9 seconds for the form, and the Blood Blossom duration is 8 seconds. Meaning, as soon as you go into the form, you have to smack them with the Blood Blossom, or do a charge attack, smack them with Blood Blossom. And then, like, you have 1 second to, like, smack them again, because, like, as soon as this ends, you're literally going to have 1 second in the form if you do this right. But usually, you're probably only going to be able to put out 1 Blood Blossom per every time. Not one as in like you're gonna put out, like you're gonna be able to put it on multiple enemies. What I'm saying is you're not gonna be able to put, like, you know, like say for example you put one on multiple enemies and then it goes off and you're gonna put another one. You can't do that, considering that her duration for her form is 9 seconds and a Blood Blossom is 8 seconds. So it's already gonna be too late by the time you even try to apply another debuff to the enemies. So anyway, yeah, the cooldown for this is 16 seconds. It's not bad, especially for a transformation that's going to be giving us so much attack based on our max HP, and also giving us even more damage with the Blood Blossom debuff. So that's going to be insane. Spirit Soother. Now, there's things to note about this. I don't want to go too much depth with this because everybody knows about this. This is where she has low HP skill damage, and she has regular skill damage, or like, so say for example, you have above 50% HP. You're going to be doing at level, let's be realistic, level 6. At level 6, you're going to be doing 399.52% damage of skill damage, regular skill damage. But when you have low HP, you're or below 50% health, you're going to do 499. That's a whopping, literally almost 100% difference. So the low HP skill damage does a considerable amount of damage. And another thing to note is once you fall below 50% health, you also get another buff from your passive, which basically when Hu Tao's HP is equal to or less than 50%, her pyro damage bonus is increased by 33%. Meaning you're going to have more pyro damage bonus, and this you're literally just going to be doing a whole bunch of pyro damage. So going to 50% health is ideal because you're going to get the low HP skill damage. You're going to, if you have your attack increase on or your activation form on, you're going to get all this buff based off your max HP depending on what level you are or what talent you are. And then you're going to literally smack because you're going to have 33% increased pyro damage, and that's all you're going to be doing is pyro damage. So that's going to be insane. And also has low HP skill regeneration and skill regeneration, HP regeneration. So you're going to be able to regenerate. You don't really need a healer. You can regenerate by yourself, literally. Like, after you, like if you have below 50% health, you will heal for on level 6, 11% of your max HP. If you have regular health, if you're above 50% health, your skill HP regeneration will be 8.25% of your max HP. So basically, the lower your health, the more you're going to hit for, the power damage bonus you're going to get. You're literally, so this character is to be played in a low health state, which is something some people are not cool with, but at the same time, it's going to be so beneficial because of what she can do in this form. So it's going to be very fun. And also another passive to note is, which isn't really, really important unless you're running a sub DPS right next to her, is her Flutterby. Basically, when Parmida Papilio's state is activated by Guide to Afterlife is all over, all allies in the party, excluding Hu Tao, will have their crit rate increased by 12% for 8 seconds. That's why I say it is for a sub DPS, for the fact that you're not going to get this, you know, 12% increased crit rate, which is kind of, it kind of sucks. So anyway, that is really Hu Tao. Like I said, this character is going to be based on a lot, and I mean a lot of HP, and also she's going to be based on pyro, mainly pyro. So let's go ahead and go to some of the artifact builds you can put on this character. And I've already made a weapons guide or weapons video for all the free to play weapons, but I'll make another video for her actual best 5-star weapon if come to need be. But at the same time, I really want to wait for her weapon banner to actually like be official. I want to see if that weapon actually comes next to her banner. Even though it looks like it's going to come next to her banner, we'll see about that and we'll discuss what is her best 5-star weapon. So anyway, let's go ahead and discuss these artifacts. Okay, so first things first, I want to talk about the Glad set. Now, people are probably thinking, yo, we're not going to do the Glad set. The reason why is the only use you'll really have for the Gladiator set is a 2-piece bonus. Why? Because the 4-piece bonus says, if the wielder of this artifact uses sword, claymore, pole arm, increases their normal attack by 35%. Now, really, on this character, you're going to be doing normal attacks, yeah, but mainly what you want to be doing is charge attacks for how much damage they're going to do. And also, another thing to note is that the charge attack applies the Blood Blossom effect. So I feel like mainly this character might be using more charge attacks than normal attacks, but correct me if I'm wrong, she may be using just normal attacks. It depends on how you actually play the character. It depends on how the character's damage is going to look when we get her in game. And we're going to see like whether charge attacks are more optimal than normal attacks, even though they're always more optimal. But we're going to see if it's like actually worth it to put a 4-piece Glad set on her. But anyway, as I was saying, 2-piece set of the Gladiators will be really, really good because of the attack plus 18%. And then also another thing to note is that you could do 2-piece Glad, 2-piece Crimson. But honestly, in my opinion, a 4-piece Crimson would work really, really well. You're probably saying, why, Whisk-chan? Why would a 4-piece set work really, really well? But, well, first off, the 2-piece bonus gives a power damage bonus of 15%. Now, if we add this 15% to her original, you know, once she drops below 50% health, she's going to have another 33% increased power damage bonus. We get literally 48% pyro damage bonus. And honestly, this is not even including if you get a goblet with pyro damage, which will also be 93% pyro damage bonus. You're literally gonna have a 93% pyro damage bonus if you have a pyro cup and you have the 2-piece bonus of the Crimson Witch of Flames, and then you go below 50% health, that's plus 33%. That totals for a total of 93% pyro damage bonus. And that is absolutely, absolutely insane. That's not even including like team comps that could get you more pyro damage, you know what I'm saying? Or pyro percentage. So anyway, as I was saying though, if you go for that, that's a lot of pyro damage. And as I said before, this unit is all about pyro damage. She's going to be doing tons and tons of power damage because of her elemental skill as well as her elemental burst. So going for a 4-piece would be very beneficial because increasing the overload and burning damage by 40%. I've already told you guys about the team guide I made about Hu Tao and how literally reactions are going to be extremely, extremely good for her, especially since she has crit damage. Increasing the overload and burning damage by 40% and also increases vaporize and melt by 15%. Using elemental skill increases the 2-piece set bonus by 50% of its starting value for 10 seconds. It has a max of 3 stacks. Now, the only problem with this is that once you do your elemental skill, you're only going to be able to do it like once. So you're not going to get the max 3 stacks like Diluc can, because Diluc can literally hit 3 times with his elemental skill and then get, you know, the max stack of 3. Well, since we can't do that, once you use the elemental skill, it will increase the regular starting value by 50%. And 50% of 15% is 7.50, which goes up to 22.50% increased pyro damage. So let's go ahead and do the math real quick. You have 115.5 or 115.50% increased pyro damage from literally doing your elemental skill and then having, you know, the 2-piece being increased by 50% of its base value. And then having, if you're below 50% health, you'd have the extra 33% increased pyro damage bonus. So you're literally looking at 115.50% pyro damage bonus, and that's going to be so good on her because, guys, as I said before, I'm not going to even stress this anymore. You're literally going to be doing tons of power damage. You have a form that transforms you to where you do all power damage. You have a elemental burst that does tons of power damage that could be triggered up to 5 times based on the number of enemies hit, and it's just insane. And then you got to remember low HP skill damage. Imagine 115.50% power damage bonus plus a crit damage build if you have, plus low HP skill damage. You're literally going to destroy everything on the field. It's not even going to be funny. It's going to be so strong. And honestly, you're probably asking, what stats should I look for on these artifacts? What stats? Well, honestly, in my opinion, what you would really look for is, you already know the flower always has flat HP. This has flat attack always. And then the witches in time. So basically the sands. What do you want on sands? Honestly, this character, you want to build her with some HP. So this is going to be pretty different. There's two ways you could do this. So on your sands, you can either have attack percent or you can have HP percent to get more HP, so that once you go into her elemental skill, you will literally have more of an attack increase and it'll be very, very beneficial. So I feel like definitely building with a HP percent on the sands would be very beneficial. But at the same time, you could offer attack percent as well if you can't, like, if you don't want to do HP. Because, you know, it's about preference. So really, but HP will probably make her, there'll have to be experiments, but HP, I feel like, will make her perform way better because of how her elemental skill works. And that's what you're going to be putting out a lot, is her elemental skill as well as her elemental burst. So definitely, I feel like HP would be really good. But at the same time, the only reason I think that it wouldn't be insane is because the HP really only applies to her elemental skill. Now, if you want to opt for, say for example, you want to opt for more of a burst doing more damage type of build, then you would opt for attack percent. The reason I say attack percent over HP on your sands is because once you opt for that attack percent, guys, the attack percent is not only going to apply to your, you know, Permita Papilio, which is your elemental skill, it's gonna apply to your Spirit Soother. Once you have like that HP stat on your sands, it won't apply to your Spirit Soother. Honestly, the only thing that would be good for Spirit Soother if you have a HP sands is the fact that you're gonna have this skill HP regeneration, low HP skill regeneration. You're gonna heal way more than normal. But if you have attack percent and you just want to hit for a lot of damage on your elemental burst, some people do that. So that's when you just put attack percent, because it's overall safe, because the Spirit Soother does not go based off max HP for doing more damage. Only the elemental skill does. So what you would want to do is do attack percent so that it could apply to your Permita Papilio, and it also could apply to your Spirit Soother. But like I said, it's up to you. HP, we're going to do tests on it once she comes out. Definitely, I'm going to have to be grinding a lot of artifacts. But anyway, the HP percent and the attack percent is very debatable, but in my opinion, attack percent is more universal. HP is more for her elemental skill to do way more damage on her elemental skill, in my opinion, and heal way more on her elemental burst. Attack percent is just to do more damage on her elemental skill and do more damage on her elemental burst. So anyway, now we have the goblet. As I said on the goblet, guys, you want to opt for power damage 100%. 100% power damage. Don't even second guess yourself. Like I said, 100% power damage. And on your witch scorching hat, honestly, you could go for HP again, or you go, yeah, you go HP again, depending. Like, say, for example, you want to do attack percent, power damage, HP. That could be fine, but at the same time, you got to remember, guys, you have to build her with some type of crit rate or crit damage. So, she has a really, really good base crit damage. If you don't run a weapon with crit rate, it'll be probably really optimal to run a crit rate build on your hat. So, getting a crit rate build with a power damage goblet with a attack percent or HP sands, which will probably be preferred to be attack percent, considering that everyone is probably going to be trying to hit big numbers on our elemental burst. But if you're just like going for consistency in her elemental skill and you want to do the max damage because of how the HP factor works with the max HP increasing your attack, then you could go for HP, pyro damage, and then you could go for crit rate. Now, if you're running a weapon that has crit rate, guys, you can go for the beautiful crit damage build. Now, this crit damage build will be really good because you could probably go up to 200% crit damage and have like 40% crit rate because of the weapon you choose, like a deathmatch maybe. But anyway, in my opinion, what I think is definitely on your substats of all your artifacts, you want crit damage, and if you can, crit rate. But if you can't, crit damage definitely, 100%. Reason I say this is because you want to build her with as much crit damage as possible. She already has a really good base crit damage, which makes it to where you could build even more. Now, she has something similar to Ganyu, and that's why it's so good, because Ganyu was actually started at 38.4%, you know, crit damage, not started actually, but like at level 80 plus and 90, you have 38.4% additional crit damage, and that's plus your 50% that you already start with naturally in the game. So actually, that's really, really good, going up to 88.4% and then having a crit damage build as well as crit damage substats. That would be absolutely insane and make her extremely strong, especially if you have above 200% crit damage and then like 30 or 40% crit rate. That's just going to be insane. She's going to be hitting for such ridiculous numbers, especially with 115% power damage. And when you're below 50% health, doing that, you know, low HP skill damage on our burst, and then you have an attack increase on your Prometa Papilio, which is the elemental skill, you're just going to be doing tons of damage around the whole game, literally. So definitely what I feel like, if you have a crit rate weapon, you want a crit damage hat, you want a pyro damage goblet on you, yeah, you want a pyro damage goblet 100%, don't change that. And you want on your sands attack percent if you want to do like numbers on your elemental burst as well as your elemental skill, or you want HP to just do tons of damage on your elemental skill as well as getting a lot of health back once you do your elemental burst. It depends on what you actually want to do. And also keep in mind, if you really, really want, there's also some other builds I want to go over after I go over the main stats that you can possibly actually, you know, get or go for. But definitely, like I was saying though, you can go for an elemental burst type build if you want to do tons of damage, see how much damage you can do on our elemental burst. That for sure is something you can look forward to and probably build if you want. We'll go over that really, really soon, but I feel like definitely if you want a consistent build for the character, really, I feel like the 4-piece Crimson Witch set, Crimson Witch of Flames will be very beneficial because of making the reactions do more damage. And then that's not even including your elemental mastery, guys. And then having the 4-piece bonus do all of what it does, increasing the 2-piece by 50% of the starting value for 10 seconds. And so, like, it's going to do so much damage and support her so much since she's doing mainly pyro. So that's why I feel like definitely this is the build to opt for 100%, a 4-piece Crimson Witch set. I feel like it's a safe set. That's my opinion. A safe set. That's what I say. But there's many other ways you could go around building this character for sure. But anyway, like I said, if you run a crit rate weapon, crit damage on your hat, pyro damage on your goblet, and on your sands, you want attack percent if you want more damage on your elemental burst and elemental skill, and HP if you just want more damage on your elemental skill, and then, you know, more regeneration on your elemental burst. So that's really, really about it for the Crimson Witch Flames of Set. But honestly, the main stats that I've told you, you should opt for them on any build you go for, whether that's the Glads if you want, whether that's the Crimson, or whether that's actually this as well, because many people probably did not guess this, but yes, the Bloodstained Chivalry set. The reason that I say that this is probably going to be a good build for her is because of her elemental skill. Now you're probably saying, yo, Whisker, she's not going to be doing physical damage, what are you talking about? That's not what I'm looking at, and honestly, this could be used for a stall until you get your elemental skill back. But the 4-piece set is what we're looking at. After defeating an opponent, this will increase your charge attack damage by 50% and reduce the stamina cost to 0 for 10 seconds. Now, the reason this is not good, but the reason this is good, is because, say for example, you're in a boss battle. Once you kill that, you're not going to be able to get this 4-piece set bonus. So it doesn't matter. You know, you might as well not even run this. But if you're in Abyss and you kill like a Healy Charl or something, Then you could get this, you know, increased charge attack damage by 50% and reduce the stamina cost to 0 second, to zero for 10 seconds. Meaning you can spam charge attacks literally for 10 seconds and the damage is increased by 50%. And if you did not know, she has a really, really big number for charge attack damage. As you can see right here, charge attack at level 15, it goes to 312. And that increase by 50% will be so, so much. It will do so much damage. And so, for sure. And then you'll be applying the Blood Blossom effect as well. So, that's why I feel like it's going to be beneficial. I feel like she's going to be more of a charge attack character. But we don't know until she actually comes out. But that's what I feel like. So, this will probably be a good set as well. But at the same time, if you're going against a boss, it's horrible. If you're not, like, going against multiple enemies, it's kind of horrible. And the physical damage bonus is horrible. So, I feel like definitely this is just going to be an experiment to try to see if the charge attack plus 50% will be way better. But I feel like it's not going to be very beneficial. This is just something that you can opt for if you want to try it out. But definitely not. This is the more optimal pick. It's a 4-piece Crimson Witch of Flame set. Because of what I've described, how it literally gives you so much pyro damage. And that's what she's literally doing the whole time. She's doing pyro damage the whole time. So, you really want to offer the 4-piece set. And then you're going to get, you know, the Pyro Goblet, you know, the Sand's going to be attack percent or HP percent, and your hat's going to be crit rate or crit damage. So I feel like it's just going to be so, so good with this set right here. And also, you can also offer this, a 2-piece Noble Sea Obliged with a 2-piece Crims. Now, the reason I say this is because of the fact that if you really want to see how high she can hit, this will increase your elemental burst damage by 20%. Which is pretty good. And then you'll still have that increased 15% power damage bonus plus your 45% on, or 45 plus percent on your goblet, as well as the, you know, 33% you get increased from being below 50% health. So I feel like the Noble Sea Obliged, you'll still have really, really good power damage bonus, but it won't be as good as 115. It'll be like 90 something. And then you'll have your elemental burst damage plus 20%. So you'll be hitting really, really hard, because your burst is going to be increased so much. And then, as you know, she has low HP skill damage. So, like, if you have low HP skill damage plus a 20% increased damage on your elemental burst, you're literally going to hit for so much damage. So, I feel like definitely this could be, like, a build. 2-piece Noblesse and 2-piece Crimson could be, like, a build to test out how much damage can she actually hit on her elemental burst. If you want to build her with a burst build and, you know, focus around that. But the Crimson Witch of Flames is really to focus on her burst build as well as her elemental skill build. But it's not going to really do as much damage as a 2-piece Crimson, 2-piece Noblesse on her burst because of this increasing the burst damage by 20%. It'll be absolutely insane. So, like I said, for sure, guys, this is going to be, like, it depends on your preference. You could do 2-piece Noblesse, 2-piece Crimson, or you could do a 4-piece Crimson, which I feel like would be the safest option. The Glad set, maybe 2-piece Glads and 2-piece Crimson. It's up to you, but honestly, in my opinion, I'm probably going to run a 4-piece Crimson Witch of Flame set. Or I'm going to run a 2-piece Crimson, 2-piece Noblesse to see how much damage she can hit for a video on her elemental burst. So definitely this is going to be really, really fun to build. I can't wait for her to come out. And that is really, really about it. So yeah, that's really her best build, in my opinion. Those are the best builds you could probably run on her for sure. You could also probably run a Wonders if you want for the reactions and whatnot. But in my opinion, the 4-piece will not be very beneficial. Really, the 2-piece will be the only thing beneficial. 2-piece plus 2-piece Crimson, maybe. Or 2-piece plus 2-piece Noblesse, depending on how you build. But in my opinion, 4-piece Crimson, which sounds the safest. Or 2-piece Crim, 2-piece Noblesse if you want a burst build. So for sure, those are the safest options you can go for. And like I said, the main stats I've already discussed with you guys. Those are the main stats that you really, really want to go for, depending on what you have as a weapon. And depending on what you want to actually run and go for on Hu Tao. So anyway, that's really about it for this video, guys, and I hope you did enjoy. I hope this did give you some insight on her best build. For sure, this took a lot of thinking because of how Hu Tao actually works. It's actually insane. This unit's actually insane, and I feel like it's gonna be a really, really good unit as long as they don't nerf her, for sure. So yeah, I really love the way she's designed. I love how she's gonna be doing tons of power damage. I love how her power damage could go up to 115% with a 4-piece Crimson Witch of Flame set. That is just, it's so beautiful. So anyway, guys, that's really about it for this video. If this video did help you, make sure you smash that like button down below. Also, join the subscribers on the grind to 2,600 by smashing that subscribe button down below. And hit the notification bell to be notified of all my daily uploads, because we do upload bangas daily. Y'all already know. So anyway, guys, I appreciate everybody who came out to watch this. I will catch you guys in the next video. Peace out.